Hello and welcome to today's extra special secret episode, not authorised by Anna. I wanted to share with you the process that I'm going to take to install a new toy that I've bought. Those of you that have been watching for a while might remember when we went out cruising in October, all I did was worry about the batteries. And that's mainly because I have no real visibility of what they're doing charge-wise. As a result, I did some research and bought a BM1 marine battery monitor, I think it's called. This is basically a display panel that connects up to the batteries via a shunt and will give a fairly accurate, hopefully, reading of the charge going in and out of the batteries, so that we can basically, when we're cruising more, can keep a better eye on what electricity we're using. There's a few things that come in the box. Most importantly, the instruction book. This is the 100 amp shunt. Gets installed in the battery bay, and all of the current has to go through it. Then there's this cable connector. The monitor itself, which has a cable coming out the back. 5 meters of cable. That's off the back of the battery monitor display. And this. Obviously, the first step is to work out where to go. So I've marked out a section here that I need to cut in the wall in order to mount the panel. I'm just going to start by drilling some holes in the corners where I need to cut the wood. Next up is the bit that I'm a little bit nervous about, which is actually cutting the wood. Got my jigsaw here, and I've checked there's no obstructions on the other side of the wood, and measured that my blade goes through okay, so here goes. The next job is to put this seal on and attach these wires into this terminal connector, and then these wires also have to go into the terminal connector. They give you a little diagram in the book. Several hours later, I have now run the cable, the 5 meter cable from the engine bay where the batteries are, through the hole in the hull, into the electrical cupboard, under the stairs, and up into the cupboard where the monitor will go, which took lots of battling. The next steps are for me to connect the shunt to the batteries, and also to connect the monitor to the shunt cable, which I think I actually do first. So I've wired the plastic cable through from the battery bank, and it now comes out this hole that I cut, and I've connected it using the terminal block following the instructions to the display panel. You line up the wires color wise and there is no second orange one unless you are connecting to your starter battery, which I'm not. I'm just in the final stages of fitting the battery monitor. The one thing to note is that it comes with a very short connector that goes from the shunt to your battery bank. So I've had to go out and buy one that's double the length, because the bit of wood that I can attach the shunt to is the opposite side of the batteries. So the battery's negative row is far away. So here's the red positive out to the monitor through the cable here. Everything else is connected into the shunt, which I've attached to the side there. There's my cable going into the negative, and everything else that was attached to the negative is attached to this side of the shunt. I've just connected everything up, and you can see there's no draw on the battery at the moment. The charge is a little bit low, it's at 83%, 84%. But that's because I haven't been charging for the last day. So I'm just gonna turn on the fridge and the toilet. And you can see the discharge value going up. I'm just gonna turn them off
again, because I've had it on for a few minutes, I've done that a few times, and now I need to connect in the solar, and then I'll turn on the battery charger as well.
I've turned on the battery charger because I'm on shore power at the moment. As you can see, the voltage has gone up, which you would expect when the batteries are charging. I guess 21 amps must be the flow that's going in, and it's going to take 5 hours to charge. So thanks for joining me for the install of my BM1 battery monitor made by NASA Marine. Full disclosure, I have had a chat with one of their engineers whilst I've been installing this product, because I made the assumption that the big beefy wire going into the batteries was the connection going back to power everything on the boat. And after I wired everything through the first time, I wasn't seeing any draw being recorded on the device when I was turning lights on. And the reason for that turned out to be because other wires go into the negative connections on the battery. And the manual does say that you shouldn't have that, but I had assumed stupidly that these were just connections to monitor the battery bank for the old legacy little dial. I was wrong, because I disconnected everything this morning to see if the monitor would suddenly start working, and then lo and behold, nothing would power on the boat. So as soon as I connected up the correct one on the shunt, suddenly it started working. You can have absolutely no other negative connectors to your batteries. So I've even got the solar connector, that the positive one goes onto the positive connector of the battery and the negative one goes onto the shunt for the battery monitor. I'm very interested to see how much power we're using, just as a general rule, and also how much solar we're generating. I'm going to put together another video where I monitor our battery usage using the battery monitor. I'll share that with you in the coming weeks. If you have enjoyed this installation video, please click like and subscribe if you aren't already and want to be notified of future videos, especially that really interesting one about battery usage. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again soon.